Hello everyone, this is Tanuja Gupta. Welcome to my channel. Have you heard about the Krange anatomy? This Krange anatomy, it is found in leaf and it is found in a special type of plants. Those plants which are found in high temperature, high intensity of light, low water concentration. So, do you have any idea if a plant is found in such a extreme condition, how they will survive? So, they survive on the basis of this Krange anatomy, okay? So, let's have a look of this Krange anatomy which comes under our main topic, that is Hatchin's Lac pathway or C4 pathway, because those plants known as C4 plants. Okay, so this Krange anatomy is found in a special type of plant. Those are called C4 plants, and the cycle occur in this C4 plants is known as C4 pathway, or it is given by a scientist named as Hatchin's Lac pathway. That is why Hatchin's Lac scientist name, so that is it is also known as Hatch and Slack pathway. Okay, so what are the example of such kind of plant, like maize, sugarcane, sorghum? So they are such plants which are comes under the category of C4 plants and responsible for maintaining the C4 cycle and have the Krange anatomy. So let's have a look how they perform this cycle so that they can survive in such extreme condition. Okay, so first of all, as what is Krange anatomy, you should know about this one. This is a leaf, and if I take a small part of this leaf, okay, so this leaf look like this. This is the upper epidermis, this is the lower epidermis, and here in Krange anatomy what happened, these are the cells which are called the mesophyll cells. Okay, they are called the mesophyll cells. Fine, here inside what happened, such a big cells are found. I'll show you. Okay, which cover the xylem and phloem. Okay, so this is the xylem and phloem. Fine, so this large cell is known as the bundle sheath cells, because it make a sheath around this vascular bundle. This is the vascular bundle. They make a sheath around this, and they make a garland like structure. Okay, they make a garland like structure. That is why it is also called as a wreath. Okay, it is called as wreath. Okay, and this is the mesophyll cell. So what happened in C4 plants, in mesophyll cells, chloroplasts are present. Okay, as in C3 plants, which we have done already in my previous video, C3 plants. So C3 plants having the mesophyll cells, okay, and they were also having the chloroplast. But what the difference in between C3 and C4? In C3 also bundle sheath cells were present, but they were not having the chloroplast. Okay, but here they have the large size of chloroplast present in the bundle sheath cells. So this also takes part in the photosynthesis, and this type of anatomy is known as the Krange anatomy. Okay, so I think you are clear about the Krange anatomy. This large size bundle sheath cell, they have the chloroplast, whereas in C3 plants they doesn't have the chloroplast. This type of anatomy is known as the Krange anatomy. Okay, so I think you are clear. Now how this anatomy perform the C4 cycle, let's have a look what happened. This mesophyll cell and this bundle sheath cell, they have the connection in between these two, and they combinedly perform this C4 cycle. Okay, so let's have a look. Okay, so this is the C4 pathway. Okay, here it is the
mesophyll cell and this is the bundle sheath cells. As I told you, they both are connected through a channel structure which is called the plasmodesmata. Okay, so what is how they are performing this cycle? First of all, in mesophyll cell, the cell capture this CO2 and it just get fixed with the help of this phosphoenol pyruvate. Okay, this is what phosphoenol pyruvate. It just take the CO2 and make and get it fixed and make a 4-carbon structure. This is the malic acid, or it may be aspartic acid, or we can directly say it C4 acids. Okay, so this make this C4 acid with the help of one enzyme here, with the help of one enzyme called the PEP-case. Okay, or it is also known as the PEP carboxylase, right? Now the C4 acid, now after formation, it just get transport through this plasmodesmata into the bundle sheath cell. Here after transportation of this C4 acid, what happened? A decarboxylation is occur, means what? The CO2 molecule, it get removed from this C4 acid, and again it become the C3 acid, which is what? Pyruvic acid. It further take part in glycolysis also. Okay, fine. And the CO2, what it do? This CO2 actually now do go for the Kelvin cycle. Okay, it bind with the RuBP and go for the Kelvin cycle. Now this pyruvic acid, it further transport back into the mesophyll cell, and again through this pyruvic acid, it get regenerated into the phosphoenol pyruvate. Okay, so this is the pathway, goes like this, and start from mesophyll cell, then into bundle sheath, and again complete into the mesophyll cell. This is the plasma membrane, outermost covering is the cell wall. Okay, so during this fixation, one molecule of NADPH is being H2 being converted into NADP. Okay, NADPH positive, and here also two molecule of ATP is being used for regeneration of the phosphoenol pyruvate. So overall in this whole pathway, around 12 NADPH2, okay, and 20 ATP are used in this whole path. Let's have a look what is the difference in between these two type of cell. They both have the chloroplast in case of C4 plant, but in C3 plant only mesophyll cell have the chloroplast. So what is the difference? Mesophyll cell has the granule chloroplast, means what? This chloroplast have a thylakoid membrane which are stacking on each other. Okay, as you know in chloroplast structure, and they make a stack like structure which is called the grana. Okay, so they have this grana chloroplast which is also present in C3 plant, whereas it contain the agranule chloroplast, and because of it, it has the absence of photosystem second activity. It doesn't have this activity, and because of it, they also show the absence of Hill reaction. Hill reaction is what? Down the hill, that Z scheme one. So they show the absence of Hill reaction. Okay, now there is an evolution of O2 in case of mesophyll cell, or you can say in C3 cycle there is an evolution of O2, but here in bundle sheath cell there is no evolution of O2 takes place, right? Okay, now in and because of this evolution of O2, it is responsible for the photorespiration. Okay, and because of this photorespiration, exactly what is this? Here O2 get bind with the RuBP instead of the CO2. Are you getting me? Here O2 get bind with the RuBP instead of CO2, and they make other product besides of phosphoglyceric acid. Okay, and because of it, it reduce the biomass of C3 plant. Okay, or it reduce the photosynthetic activity or product in C3 plant. But where here is, there is no O2 evoluted, and it also makes sure that there is a high production of CO2. So only CO2 will get bind with the RuBP and make sure there is a high productivity. Okay, and one more thing, there is an absence of Rubisco in mesophyll cell. In mesophyll cell, there is an absence of rubisco only in C4 plant, right? Whereas in bundle sheath cell, they show the presence of rubisco. So that is why the C3 cycle is taken place in bundle sheath cell only, okay? Here, the C3 cycle, or you can say Kelvin cycle, doesn't take place in case of C4 plant. So I hope this funda is clear to all of you. So you can see here CO2 is being produced. So that is why it make ensure there is no photorespiration of RUBP taken place in case of C4 plant. Okay. And one more thing also, here 2-time carboxylation is taking place, or you can say double carboxylation is taking place. What happened here? First CO2 is being fixed over here, so this is the first carboxylation, and here which CO2 is released, it also get fixed through the Kelvin cycle. So this is the second carboxylation. Okay. Yes, one more point it was remaining, which I should told you earlier, why it is called C4 pathway, because here the first product is the 4-carbon compound. That is why it is called the C4 pathway. Okay. And there is no photorespiration taken place in C4 plants. That is why this cycle is more efficient, as compared to the C3 cycle. Okay. So I hope this C4 cycle is clear to all of you. If you have any doubt, write in comment box. I will feel very happy to clear your doubts. And if you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe my channel, and yes, keep on motivating me by press the like button. Okay, so thank you so much guys for watching this video. Thanks a lot.